Okay, Ashley, I wanted to show you how to bind off because I didn't want to leave you hanging today. So when you go to bind off, we can either bind off in pattern to keep it looking the same, or we can bind off knit. I'm going to show you in pattern so that we will bind off the knit stitches knit-wise and the purl stitches purl-wise. So you're going to knit two. And then pick up the first stitch and slide it over the second, leaving the second stitch on. So we've got the knit stitch there. Then we're going to purl the next stitch. Oops. And do the same thing. We're going to bring, I just moved the yarn to the back because it's easier for me. Bring that stitch up and over. So we've got two bound off. Then we'll purl this stitch and do the same thing again. Bring that stitch over. I think I'm holding it too high, so I'll show you. So I've knitted the stitches. And then just bring this one and bring it through. With the two knit stitches, I'm going to knit one and then bring that stitch over that one. Knit that stitch and bring that over. And what that does in pattern, the purls will look like purls, the knits are just fine. So it kind of gives it a nice edging. So there you go. That's how you bind off. And let me get to the end and I'll show you how to finish it. So I'm back. I'm down to the last stitch to bind off. I need to move the camera far. I keep bumping it and sliding it off. There we go. Okay. So I'll knit this last stitch, and then yarn over. So I'm at the end, and now I'm going to just pull this loop through a little bit and take the tail, I've already cut it, and pull that through. So there's the swatch, and it, when you bind off in pattern, then it kind of gives you that little wave because the purls, it'll keep it together nicely. Yes, Flicka, give me a minute. Okay, now to check the gauge, just need a trusty little measuring tape. I got this one at Walmart for about, it was under $2. It was $1.94. And I don't have the pattern with me, so I don't know what it calls for, but it's, we need to see how many stitches we have in 4 inches. And in the ribbing, it's a little tougher because it's tight, so we have to kind of stretch it out a little bit. So basically we can see that we have pretty much 4 stitches per inch. So that'd be 4, 8, 12, 16 stitches. And when we're knitting, you know, it'll be easier. It's just V's per inch. So we do, here's one V, there's another V. The purls are a little tougher to do because it's hard to see. But there's one stitch, there's another stitch. Because sometimes it's a garter stitch where it all looks like this, and then we have to figure out the gauge from that. But then we've got two more V's. So it's about 16 stitches for 4 inches. And because you've gone the full 30, they want to have so many rows per 4 inches. I didn't go that far. But that exactly what you would do here is count the V's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I have 7 stitches, 7 rows per inch. But I think that one was in 18 inches. They wanted you to have, like, maybe, I don't know how many rows. Might have been 23. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, actually, yeah, 7. So I have 7 rows per inch on that one. So I hope that helps.